Hello, my name is Yvonne from the German Projector for Sewing Facebook group. In my videos I explain to you the programs Inkscape and Affinity Design. I would be happy about a thumbs up. Feel free to subscribe to my channel to not miss any new video. You are a designer and need support or help to convert your files? Feel free to send me a message via the website below. In this video I'll show you how to connect lines or object parts using Affinity Designer version 2. This is only needed if you want to add seam allowance later, or it usually makes it easier for you to further edit the cut parts. But it is not necessary. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to write me in the comment. If you now have a pattern where you have already joined the sides, then you can remove the lines here. To do this, you might have to ungroup them. You can see that here on the right. To ungroup, just right-click and say Ungroup All. The best way to do this is to select everything with Ctrl and A and do this once. The parts are already entire objects and have no individual lines. We don't have to do anything here. In the case of the sleeve, we see that it is not yet joined. We can simply remove the frame around it, as well as the number. Now I'm going to take one sleeve piece and just push it to the other one, just like you put pages together in the first place. Next, we can now join these two object lines together. Especially if you plan to add a seam allowance, the pattern piece must be an object, otherwise the seam allowance will only be added around the individual lines. You now select the Knot tool, which is the third button. Next, you click on the first object line, press Ctrl and Shift and click on the next line. You can do this as often as you like, depending on how many lines you have. We have here two single lines and I click here on Join Curves, and now we have only one object. Sometimes it doesn't work right away. You have to mark the knots first. In the case of this knot here, you can do that with Ctrl and A. If this does not work correctly, because it does not recognize the knots correctly, then you have to select the knots you want to connect one by one. I usually draw a small rectangle, then it is easier than clicking on the individual points. Now you have to do that for each size separately. Sometimes it is also helpful to split the image into layers at the beginning and then connect the lines. It depends on whether you plan to do it anyway or not. There is also a video about creating layers. I'll move one of the connected objects here and we'll see that we are still missing the fold line. I recommend not cutting on the fold with a projector, especially with a UST. Therefore, you could simply duplicate and mirror the whole thing without the fold line. However, I still like to have the fold line in it. This often helps me with a grain line or when I have to push the fabric. To insert this line, we select the two knots, top and bottom, and also say Join Curves again. And now it automatically inserts a straight line. Now, of course, I've pulled out the fabric just for you to see it better. Otherwise, I wouldn't do it, because it's stupid to reset it now. So you do this now with every object if you need it. Here I see, for example, the line is missing. I can also simply mark the knots with Ctrl and A and connect the knots. That was a simple object. However, some objects are constructed like this skirt here. Unfortunately, there are no whole lines here, but the lines are divided into many single fragments. Here on the right in the overview, you can see that nicely. First there are greens, then comes some yellow, then greens again, then red, and so on. So here it gets a bit trickier. In this card, we have the advantage that the lines are colored. So we have a colored distinction of these lines here. If all lines are black, it will be more difficult. Not impossible, but difficult. Then I can only recommend tracing the cut. This is much faster than trying to find the lines together. Especially if the lines should cross each other, it will be a more difficult task. With a colored one, you can of course simply trace it or just connect the points. To connect the points, you can mark them in the overview on the right. So click, hold Shift key and mark the points, or press the Shift key and then go to the last point to be marked. Now all the individual points have been made into a line. And now you have to do these steps for all colors or lines. So select the next color, click on connect knots, and then you have connected the next line. You can't do this for all colors at the same time, otherwise it would connect your lines in a mess. Step by step. To connect the fragments, click on them one after the other and connect them. Now we mark these two points and connect them with a line. And then we mark these two points and connect them with a line. And now this should give us a complete skirt part. Of course, we do the same with other lines. This is how you can connect the individual lines. Whether this is faster than tracing or not, that's up to you. You can also watch my video on tracing lines and then make your own decisions. We are at the end of this video. I hope it was helpful to you. You can find more videos about Affinity Designer on my channel. Feel free to leave me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I wish you good luck with your projects. See you soon. Bye!